Hi all, this video will be first part in a series of videos on how to create a SpeedGauge application for Nokia Symbian 3 and MeeGo phones. You can find my app in Ovi Store. It costs 99 cents. By buying the app, you can support this tutorial. Creating these tutorials takes a lot of my time. My tutorials are free to watch and I will try to keep them this way. Please support these tutorials by buying the app. The Symbian app is available and MeeGo app will also be available soon. The app lacks some functionalities, like measuring speed in miles per hour, but I hope I will add them in the future releases. For now, this app is useful just as a showcase for these tutorial videos. Okay, let's get started. First of all, start Qt Creator. Let's create a new Qt project by clicking on File, New file or project. Then choose Qt project and Qt quit application. I will choose the name SpeedGauge tutorial. Click next. At Qt quick application type, choose Qt quick components for Symbian. We will create app for Symbian phones and then we will modify the app so it will work on MeeGo devices. If you are interested only in MeeGo app, you should choose Qt Quick Components for MeeGo Harmattan. Leave Symbian device and Qt Simulator checked. Click Next. If you have an SVG icon, you can change it. I won't do that now. Leave the target UID free as it is. Click Next and Finish. So nothing new here, as a result we've got main QML and main page QML files. You can get a detailed explanation on what these files do in my Hello World tutorial. Just click on the pop-up on the screen if you want to watch that movie. Now we will add some pictures to the app. We will need the background picture, which will contain the dial, and the picture of a needle that will rotate. Now, I won't give you the graphic files I have used for the app that is in the store. You will have to create those yourselves. The files I will provide you with are not that pretty, but they are adequate for learning. To acquire the files, you should visit my blog, mobiledevvt.blogspot.com. You can find the link in the description below this video. Find the post Qt SpeedGauge tutorial 1. Read the post because it contains some additional information. Inside the post you will find useful links. Among them there will be a link. Click here to download the graphics. Accept the downloaded file. After downloading the SpeedGauge gfx.zip file, you will see it contains two PNG files. We are going to add these files to our project. In Project Explorer, right-click on QML and choose Show in Explorer. This will take you to the folder containing your QML files. Create a new folder here called IMG. This will hold our images. Let's copy the file we just downloaded to the folder IMG. Also, let's rename the file igla.png to needle.png. In the design view, we will add these images. Drag and drop image element to the main page. Choose the SpeedGauge PNG. We will position this image, set X and Y to 0 so that it aligns with the top left corner. Our image is 360 pixels wide and 640 pixels high. I will enter these measurements. If the text gets behind the image background, reposition it so that it is on the top. Drag one more image element. Adjust its position and load the image. Let's check the size of the original file. 119 by 45 pixels. Adjust the position of the needle image. I know these numbers will be okay because I was playing out with them. 20 pixels from the left and 310 from the top. I'm going to change the identifier of the image element to needle so I can recognize it more easily. We will introduce a new property. Type of the property is double because it will hold a number. The name of the property is needle angle. The initial value will be 0. This property will act as a variable. You can find more information about the properties in my blog that is accompanying this video under Learn More section. You can find the link to my blog post under this video. Now we will handle the rotation of the needle. We will add a rotation object to the transform property of the image. Origin X and origin Y define where is the point around which we are rotating the whole image. This point will be center of rotation. You have to play around a little bit with these numbers to get perfect results. I have already done that, so I know that these numbers will work fine. Angle defines the angle of rotation. Smooth is used for nicer graphics. If you want to know more on rotation, visit my blogspot and look for the link under the Learn More section. You will find the link to related blogspot in the description below this video. Something is wrong here. You can tell that by the color. I got it. I used brackets and instead I should have used curly brackets. There, the color is normal now. We want to test the app, so we will add two buttons here. One will increase the angle and the other will decrease it. The buttons should be children of the main page and not the children of the background element. Looks like the button 1 is positioned off the screen, so we are going to reposition it. There it is. Play around with these buttons until they don't look nice. We will name the buttons. BTN is short for button. Let's reposition the text. If we put it up, it will be behind the background and it won't be visible. Let's put it on top of the images. There. Our text element will be used to tell us what is the current angle of the needle. I think I don't need these two lines. Let's just fine-tune this so it looks nicer. Every time I click on the plus button, I want my needle to rotate to the right. Every time I click on my minus button, I want it to rotate to the left. I will create on-click handlers that will increase and decrease the value stored inside the needle angle property by 10. Let's try this out in a simulator. We can see that the bottom toolbar is in the way of our buttons. You have to be careful because even the screen is 360 by 640, the status bar on top and toolbar on bottom eat out part of your screen real estate. But you can see that if I click on the plus button, the needle rotates clockwise. It is rotating all the way, so we will have to stop it when it reaches the maximum. Minus button also works. We also have to stop it there. Let's exit the app. Okay, it looks like we are out of time. We have covered a lot of things today. In our next tutorial, we will remove the bottom toolbar. We will stop the needle from going too far to the left or right. And we will disable the app rotation on Symbian free devices and on MeeGo device. On my blog, you can find the download links to code from QML files. Afterwards, you can copy and paste the code here in Qt SDK. You can also find the graphics files. Everything is in the download section. You can also find links under the Learn More section. So be sure to visit the blog. The link is below this video. Next tutorial will follow soon. Subscribe, like and share. Don't forget on the app on the Ovi Store. It will work only on Symbian free phones. Earlier versions of Symbian are not supported and are not in the plans for now. MeeGo app will follow soon. Bye.